Welcome back to the channel. As you already know, it's Director Vim here. And today it's quite simple, man. It's just a little vlog type of story that I want to share on the channel today, so that you guys can be, vigilant, so that you guys can be careful whenever you guys are going out there for such business. Okay, so you guys do know that on the other hand, I'm a businessman as well. Businessman, in terms of buying and selling. So for some time now, I've been hustling more on the internet side, like OLX, Facebook Market, Gumtree, and all those platforms. So yes, some days ago, I think I went on the market platform, and then there was a car that I actually wanted to purchase. I think the price was actually listed for 50, if I'm not mistaken. And then I spoke with the lady, and then we all came to an agreement in terms of negotiations and all that. I even chat with her on WhatsApp. And the crazy part is, I told her that I'll be coming the following day to view the car, and then if everything is perfect, I make the payment and then we're done. So on the phone, when you're talking to a lady and the conversation is proper, you won't even think, worry, there is something dodgy going on, especially when it's a lady. If it was a guy, I would probably know that I need to be careful here. So the following day, the next morning, I went all the way. I think she sent me the location. She was living in Tembisa. I drove there, but I think before that, before me driving to the place, the car that I actually wanted to purchase from her, a Honda, is it a Civic? Yeah, Honda Civic. Those portable ones, the one that my friend Osman is using. That car is very light on petrol, man. You put 100 rand, you go to Zim, you come back. Osman, you know yourself. So yes, man, that was the type of car that I was actually buying from her. She said the car needed a bit of attention, but it wasn't engine related. It was just body issue, which I could sort out. So yeah, I drove all the way in the morning because I spoke to her that evening, and then I said I would be there around 9. So I think I went there, and I didn't actually inform her that I'm on my way. So when I got, I think, few minutes away, around 10 minutes, 8 minutes, then I phoned her. I'm like, hey, how are you? She's like, hey, everything is fine. Before she even answered, I was trying to reach out to her many times. She wasn't answering the call, both WhatsApp and normal call. So she called later. She's like, hey, who is this? I'm like, hey, I spoke with you last night with regards to the Honda. So I'm almost there at the location you sent me to pick up the car. Man, the lady said, hey, I'm somewhere, I'm not available now, someone will come and get you, so just give me a few minutes, the person is coming. I waited and waited and waited. I waited until Isa almost gave up. So Isa is the driver that I went with. It's a good guy, man. Shout out, Isa. So yeah, I went with Isa all the way to Tembisa. I don't know what her intentions or their intentions was, but I think the dodgy thing that I saw was the area, the location that she sent me. Man, this is not a location whereby you can actually survive a second there. Like, this was deep Tembisa area, whereby when we got there, there were some guys sitting, smoking. Like, hey, man, this place looks dodgy, man. So I actually missed my location in terms of the street. You know how the street location is. So I got out from the car. I went to one of the guys. I don't want to show worry. The guy is from Bagana. So yeah, I just dressed normally. I went there. Then I'm like, hey Joe, I'm looking for, the street name is Muedi. Yeah, Muedi Street, somewhere on Muedi. Tembisa, I'm not sure if there's any guy from Tembisa watching this. If you're watching this, please drop it in the comment section. I want to know how that area is. So the street name was Muedi. She said section 70, Muedi Street. Yeah. So I got down, I went to the guy, like, hey, Joe, Like, hey Joe, I'm looking for more this street, hey Joe, so where can I find it? I just go down there. Now I went all the way down there. The lady is still not coming. I also don't see any car. I waited for a while, still nothing. I tried to call her, still nothing. I'm like, what are these guys trying to do? Because I mean, we spoke and we said I should come at 9, and I didn't even come late. I was actually there like 8:30 something, if not 40 something. I waited until it was 9 something, still nothing. I tried to phone her, no answer. Later on, I tried again, the phone was off. Then I told this, okay, let's bounce, man, because normally my day schedule, I don't make it one. When I make a schedule for cars, I make sure that, okay, in that area, I check two or three, so that in case one doesn't work out, the other one will work out. So I told this that, man, the lady is not answering, and this is crazy, man. This is fishy. Let's get out of here. So yeah, we via from there. We left that place, and the crazy thing is, when I was on my way going to check the other car, I sent her a message. Cause myself, I didn't actually understood what was happening. Then I'm like, hey, was this a scam or something? No reply. And I sent another message that I'm going to report her account. Then she sent back a message saying, what is she? Check this out. When I sent, were you trying to scam me? She said nothing. Then when I say I'm going to report your account, she was like, I was not scamming you. The problem, I don't trust Nigerian guy. They are full of scammers. If you are not Nigeria, I would sold it to you. So I heard your, this is not even heard. She's even speaking rubbish English here. So I heard your tone that you are Nigerian. I'm hurt. I'm hurt. But I mean, it's crazy, man. Let's just assume if I'm a Nigerian. If I'm a Nigerian, then what? No, if I am a Nigerian, or if I sound like a Nigerian, then what? Because now, based on what she's saying that, okay, so I sound like a Nigerian, hence she cannot sell me the car. Man, you know, sometimes some people can be dumb, man. I don't know whether it is a scam that she was trying, but it didn't work out, maybe because I didn't inform her earlier that I'm coming for them to make preparations, rather informing her when I was few minutes away from the spot. So I don't know if it was a scam that she wanted to, I don't know. Or it's truly what she meant, like me being a Nigerian. Man, that's crazy. And that's especially when it's coming from an African. Man, I think it's time we Africans we pull up our socks, man, because it's not the first time I'm actually seeing or experiencing such. Normally at on other incidents, people will judge you based on, I mean, where they think you're from. I mean, if I'm a Nigerian, I want to buy your car, not to steal your car. So why not at least come out and then show me the car that you're selling, that, hey, this is the car, this is this. Or if you don't feel safe and you think a Nigerian will scam you, why not arrange a meeting at the police station or something than putting this out there? I mean, sometimes, especially in South Africa, man, a lot of people feel or think if someone is a Nigerian, the person is a scammer. And that's a big problem that we're actually facing or going through in most countries. I'm not sure about other countries because most of the experience that I've had or seen is South Africa. So I don't know. But I went to a profile and I checked, because normally when someone posts, they post based on, I mean, you only have to use an account. You have to be registered with Facebook before you can start selling on Marketplace. And For you to sell on marketplace, you need to be, I mean, on Facebook for quite some time now. I think before it used to be more months, if not 9 or 10, but now I think they've reduced it to a few weeks or so. So I went to a profile and then I checked. Everything seems legit. There's photos, yeah, which looks real, and then the details are also making a bit of sense. But now, if you see the face of the lady who is talking about a Nigerian being a scammer, it's a pity, man. It's a pity because when now when you got a new car, you want to sell your car, and at the same time you are still judging other nationalities. Like what the man, like just look at the face of this lady who is complaining about a Nigerian. And Kishore, yeah, I say, like she doesn't even have. I don't know, man. I don't know. I'm pretty. I don't know what her past experience are with Nigerians, but I mean, no matter what, I know that sometimes when it comes to buy and sell, there are some people. I won't say Nigerians. There are some people who intend to fuck up things for us. I mean, sometimes they'll say, "Hey, can you give the Uber driver, I'm going to make the transfer to you. I'm going to send my brother to come and collect the item. Can I pay you an installment?" I understand. But that doesn't mean we should blame all this on Nigerians. I mean, there are a lot of people who, even South Africans, are doing this. There are a lot of South Africans who are scamming people. There are Tanzanians scamming people. There are Angola, a whole lot. So we shouldn't always try to put things on, I mean, Nigerians. I mean, it's crazy, guys. It's crazy. And that reminds me that Nigerians are really going through a lot in this country, man. A lot. But anyway, let me know what your thoughts and comments are based on this whole incident. It's crazy, guys. It's crazy. But yeah, thank you very much for watching. If you are new on the channel, slap on the subscribe button, like the video as well. What we do here is entertainment with a mixture of cinematography. Yeah. I'll see you in the next one. Peace.